In our first Excel video, we looked briefly at some of the basic ways to calculate numbers. In the next few videos, we're going to look at Excel in more depth. Before we do anything else, it's important to remember that a number can represent many different things. The number 7, for example, could be all sorts of things. Apart from being a number, it could be a currency, it could be part of an accounting set, it could be a date, it could be a time or a percentage, it could be a fraction, it could even be text. Excel can't guess. So before doing anything else, you need to tell Excel what your number represents. You do that by formatting the data using the number block in the Home ribbon at the top of the workbook. By default, Excel will give your number a general format, which, as the name implies, means that the number you've entered is not formatted for anything. As numbers go, it's a blank canvas, ready to become whatever you want to make it. It's perhaps more accurate to say that you format the cell, or the range of cells, into which you're placing the numbers, rather than the number itself. We'll select a column of cells, here, and then go to the number block in the Home tab at the top of the workbook. The drop-down box gives you a range of options. We'll look at them all in just a moment. Select Number for that column. If you select a cell in the column to the left, you'll see that its format is General, because we've not applied any formatting to that cell. But select any cell in the column we've just formatted, and it will show Number, even without any data entered. That's an important memory point, because it's too easy to enter a number into a cell that's already been formatted with something you don't want, and then find that Excel doesn't behave as expected. Now, let's enter a few numbers. You'll see that by default, Excel will display the number to 2 decimal places in the formatted column. If you want, you can change this by using the 2 buttons here. But 2 decimal places is usually sufficient, and probably exactly what you'll need if you're working with money. But you can also format your numbers as currency, and Excel will add the default currency symbol and a comma separator for large numbers. However, the currency symbols aren't aligned, and trying to line everything up by using spaces is both time-consuming and inaccurate. You can overcome this by using the accounting format. Excel will align the currency symbol and the decimal points. The accounting format is very useful, but if, like me, you find the repeated use of a currency symbol distracting, you can turn it off. The small down arrow at the bottom right of the numbers box produces a pop-up box that gives you many more formatting options. And to get rid of that pesky currency symbol, simply click None. Excel gives you a huge range of options for presentation, and we'll look at these later in a video on layout and presentation. In order to work with dates, you need the date format. Again, Excel gives you a number of options for presentation. Working with time requires its own format, which you can define here. Formatting a number as a percentage can be very useful as well, and once specified, can be used in calculations. 100 times 50% is 50. You can format cells to work with fractions. Here, for example, I've entered 1/4 as a fraction, and I've used it in a calculation. Using the sum tool, we can multiply 100 by 1/4 to give 25. Scientific format is complex and beyond the scope of this introductory video, but the final format option, text, is both useful and important to know. If you define a cell as text, you can type anything into the cell simply as text. It can't be used in calculations, but it's very important when creating layouts and explanations. So there it is. The first step in working with Excel is to know what kind of data you're working with and to define your cells to the correct format for that data. In the next video, we'll look at how to work with some of these different formats to create slightly more complex calculations. eTop Technology. We're here to help. If you like these videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you found this video helpful, check out some of our most recent videos. And if you're looking for a new IT partner, please visit our website.